Hi everyone, my name is James and welcome to my YouTube channel. Today I want to show you what I consider the perfect shoe collection. What I mean by perfect is not only does this collection have a shoe for every season, but also for every occasion. So I think everyone is going to find something they like in this collection. One thing to point out before we get into the collection is that I do buy my shoes to wear them. And the ones I'm showing you today, I do genuinely wear a lot. So they are a little bit dirty, and apologies in advance if that grosses you out a bit, especially in the up close shots. Oh, and in case anyone's wondering, the socks are from H&M. They are these beige organic cotton socks. Very cheap and affordable. To start off, you've heard it in every shoe collection ever, you need a basic white sneaker. My pick for today is the Converse Chuck 70. This is a very well established shoe and you've probably all seen it before, and that's for good reason. It is probably the perfect white sneaker. It comes in a low and a high top. I've obviously got it in the high top version here. I prefer the high top because it's the classic Chuck look. Also, it's versatile because you can choose to show off the high top or not, depending on the length of the trousers you're wearing. One thing to keep in mind is that this is the Chuck 70, not the regular Chuck Taylor. It's a very subtle but very meaningful difference, and I really advise looking into it because the Chuck 70, in my opinion, is a far superior shoe. There are a few ways to tell whether you're getting a Chuck 70 if you're not sure, but the main giveaway is that it will actually say 70 on the badge here. You'll also notice that this logo is in black and white and it's stitched on in this leather patch. You can get variations of this with certain collabs, but usually it'll look like this. Regular Chucks will have a white, blue and red patch, which is just screen printed on. The next thing you'll notice about the 70s is that the canvas used is pretty much twice the thickness. This means that the shoes hold their shape way better, and they're just higher quality, they're gonna last you for longer. Third, the sole is gonna be in this sort of off-white vintage color rather than a brilliant white. This is such a nice but subtle difference. You'll also notice on the back of the shoe that it says Converse All-Star but in black rather than white as it does on the regular Chucks. Even the laces on the 70s are far superior to the regular Chucks. They're just thicker and better quality. And the final advantage of the 70s over the regular Chucks is actually the insole. It's way, way more comfortable. You honestly have to try them on to believe it. I've got loads of pairs of regular Chucks, but the 70s are just a completely different shoe, even though they look exactly the same. There is a little bit of a price increase between the regulars and the 70s, but it's definitely worth the investment. I actually have these in white and black, but because it's spring summer, I'm showing off the white ones today. In my experience, I would go true to size with these. Even though there's a little bit of room at the end of the toe, I've tried sizing down half a size and it was a terrible decision. They were way too uncomfortable and obviously too tight because my big toe went numb and it didn't come back for months. Okay, so that's the white sneaker, but we all know everyone needs a black sneaker as well in their collection. And you've definitely seen this all before. For me, it is the Vans Old Schools. And this is a perfect example of what I was talking about earlier with how much I wear my shoes, because these are totally beaten up. In fact, I'm probably due a new pair, but actually I quite like the way these look when they're beaten up. I really don't have to go into much detail. You probably all own a pair of these, but Vans Old Schools are probably the most versatile shoe you can buy. I think because they're so popular, they have just become so widely accepted in various situations. So obviously people wear these skateboarding and on casual occasions, but I've also seen them on nights out and even at work. If for some reason you don't have a pair yet, they're really affordable to buy new, but also there's such a strong secondhand market for these. You could probably pick up a pair for like £10 to £15. Sizing for these, I recommend just going true to size and I think you'll be absolutely fine. All right, next up is my sort of everyday shoe, and you will have seen it if you saw my last video, and it's the New Balance 991s. As I said in my last video, I sort of traded in my 574s looking for something a bit higher quality, and I landed upon the 991s, which I just thought was a beautiful silhouette. This is a made in England shoe, and you can definitely tell there's a step up in materials and construction. It's a really sturdy, bulky feeling shoe. It feels so well put together, and all the materials are just buttery smooth. On top of that, it is extremely comfortable, definitely one of my most comfortable in the collection. And as I said, this is my sort of everyday shoe. When I don't know what to wear, this is what I go for now. I picked them up in the classic gray colorway. I thought this was great because I had my perfect white sneaker, my perfect black sneaker, and now this is something in between. Now that I've got these in hand, I'm definitely looking at other 900 series because I just know it'll be a great investment. They are a little bit pricey though, so I definitely have to look for a few bargains if I want to get more of these. In terms of sizing, I went for my true size 9 and my foot is a standard width, so that's fine. But these are a little bit narrow, so if you've got particularly wide foot, you might want to size up half a size. Okay, next up are my sort of smarter shoes, and I've got two different pairs to show off. First up are the Clarks Wallabies. This is easily Clark's most recognizable shoe, and I think a lot of people have a sort of love-hate relationship with this. These are great because they fit into any smart occasion, especially in summer, but also you can wear them very casually. I've worn these with joggers and I think they look great. This is the maple suede color, which is probably the most classic color. They come in loads of different colors though, and there are a lot of different collaborations with this model in particular. They have an all suede upper, which is really nice, feels really good quality. They've got this sort of gummy sole, which is surprisingly comfortable to walk on actually. I wore these all day walking around in Italy and they were absolutely fine. However, the gummy sole is a bit of a nightmare because of how dirty it gets. You can see here, it's pretty much gone completely black. It is an absolute magnet for dirt and grime. So if you wear these outside even once, expect to get them extremely dirty. In terms of sizing, I went half a size down and they fit me really good. Okay, my next pair of smarter shoes are gonna be the Dr. Martens Adrian loafers. These are for much more formal occasions where I think the Wallabies are a little bit too casual, but these still can be worn very casually and I do that very often. So I've been looking for a pair of loafers for quite a while. I've tried a lot of different brands, but I never really loved any of them. And I'm a big fan of Dr. Martens, but I didn't even know they did loafers. So when I saw these, I was extremely excited. And another thing that excited me are these are their Made in England range as well. And just like with my clothing, I'm always trying to move towards more high quality pieces. So everything sort of fell into place with these and I picked them up and I couldn't be happier. I just think these are such a good looking shoe. They're so chunky and robust, and because they're made in England, they're really well put together and all the quality of the materials is very high. Because of the black leather and the shape of the shoe, they can easily fit into a formal or smart environment. But because of the tassels on the front and the classic Doc Martens yellow stitching, you can wear them as a very casual shoe as well. On top of that, because of the airwear sole, they're extremely comfortable. Again, I've worn these all day with no problem. In my opinion, there are not many loafers that look better than this, no matter the price range. It's a little bit on the pricey side, but nothing compared to some other loafers I've seen on the market. But I'm wearing these for date nights, nights out, when I go on holiday. This is just a great investment for me. For sizing, I went true to size and they fit me great. Okay, next up, I have some more summery hot weather options. And the first option is gonna be the Birkenstock Boston Clogs. You might have already seen these before because they're becoming very popular, especially this summer. So these are exactly what they sound like. They're clogs. So they've got this really sort of bulbous toe, but then they're like hybrid sandals as well. So you can just slip them on at the back. The upper is all suede and it is extremely nice quality. It's really buttery and it's really thick as well. I got it in the taupe colorway, which I think is the nicest colorway for this shoe. It also has nice copper buckle and button details. Then the insole is pretty much all made of cork, so it sort of molds to your foot and becomes really comfortable after time. If you've ever looked at the secondhand market for Birkenstocks, it's quite funny because it does mold to people's feet. You see people's footprints on the cork and it looks kind of gross actually. And then on the bottom, you've got this quite thick, grippy sole as well. So they're quite suitable for walking outside, even though they just look like slippers. Now, this is definitely one of Birkenstock's more premium shoes. And these are actually made in Germany and you can really tell. All the materials feel really nice. It feels really well constructed and is extremely comfortable. The way I wear these is if I just need to pop out somewhere quickly or just around the house. They're definitely not the type of shoe you want to be going out with for long periods of time. And that's because they're essentially like slippers. Even though I got these in the correct size, they do still slip off, so I wouldn't want to be walking long distances in these. Talking about sizing, you can kind of get away with going a size up or down by a half because they are slip-ons. so you have quite a bit of give at the back. So even if you went down a size, you'll still find that you'll be able to fit into them. If all sizes are available, just go for your true size and you'll be golden. Now, if I was going to be walking long distances in the summer, I would go for this pair of Birkenstocks. These are the Birkenstock Arizonas, and they are the leather version rather than the EVA version, which is like a plasticky version. I did actually pick up a pair of the EVA version first of all, because I wanted a pair which would be waterproof, and because they're made of plastic, you can wear them in the water. However, they broke on me instantly, so I instead upgraded to the leather version, which, like the Bostons, is made in Germany, so they're made of much better materials and much better put together. So you can see for yourself, the Arizona is a two-strap sandal. They come in a lot of colors, but I just got them in the black leather. The leather is really nice quality, and they've got that cork insole again, so they're really comfortable and they're gonna mold to your feet eventually. And then that thick outer sole as well, so they're very suitable for walking outside. And as I said, these are great for long distance walking, especially in the hot or summer weather. Because of those two straps, your feet stay put and they're not gonna slip off. I'm definitely a socks and sandals guy. I think they look great. Come at me. As for sizing, similar to the Bostons, because they're a slip-on, you can essentially get away with going half a size up or down, depending on what's available. But if all sizes are available, just go for your true size. Okay, going into boots and sort of winter footwear next. First pair I want to show you are these incredible Red Wing mock toes. So I'm sure all my American viewers are very aware of Red Wing already, but perhaps some of my European viewers are not. These are a made in USA boot, and I see them as like the American Doc Martens. They're an incredibly high quality, well put together, sturdy boot, which are essentially heirloom pieces. They're gonna last you most of your lifetime. Here I have them in their most famous colorway, which is called Oro Legacy. It's like a red orange color with this sort of off-white cream sole. They've got a Goodyear welt. If you know what that means, then you know way too much about shoes. These are an absolutely great winter boot, but actually I wear them all year round. I think they look great with like a dark blue pair of jeans, but I even wear these with shorts. They're an extremely heavy boot and they do require a lot of breaking in, so keep that in mind if you're buying them new. You all know I love my Doc Martens, but I felt like I needed something a little bit different. This has a slightly different silhouette with the mock toe, and obviously it's in this crazy sort of orange red color. They definitely look a little bit like clown shoes, but I love them. One thing I will say about these is they are probably the most difficult shoes to get on. They're definitely not like a slip-on, slip-off shoe. It's a bit of an ordeal getting them on and off. But once they're on, they're really comfortable, especially if you've broken them in. Sizing on these is pretty crazy. You're probably gonna wanna go a full size down on these. Okay, and you've heard me mention them, and you know I can't leave them out. It's the Doc Martens 1460s. By far my most worn boot. I wear them all year round. I think they go with absolutely everything, and you can wear them to any occasion. These are the very basic, cheapest 1460s, and they've held up really well. But I'm definitely looking to get a Made in England pair, because I know they make those. So when these finally give up on me, I'll probably look to get a pair. If you haven't got any black boots in your rotation, these are a great starter pair, because they're very well priced, and they look great. In terms of sizing, I went true to size, and actually I reckon I could have gone half a size down. Okay, and the last shoe, finishing up on the sort of winter outdoors vibe, and they are these, which are the Nike ACG Terra Zaharas. I am not sure if I'm pronouncing that correctly. These are a little bit of a novel shoe, but I thought I'd include them because I have been wearing them a lot recently. So those of you who know Nike ACG, ACG stands for All Conditions Gear, and what I mainly wear them for is walking. So very recently, me and some friends walked up Snowdon and I wore these and they held up extremely well. But I'm also planning on wearing them a lot more during the summer, just for easy hikes and long walks. They are probably one of my most comfortable pair of shoes. They've got this sock lining, which means they're really snug and comfortable on your foot. And they've got this huge chunky cushion sole, which is extremely comfortable to walk around in. They're really grippy, as you can imagine, so they're perfect for outdoors. And they're also water resistant as well. I actually think they look really good too. I find myself wearing them quite a lot, especially if I need to pop out really quick and it's raining outside. These are so easy to pull on with the sock lining and the tab. The lacing system is really nice as well. Like, you pull the laces and they all tighten up, which can't be said for a lot of shoes. Plus, they have that sort of dad shoe vibe, don't they? Which I'm loving at the moment. And so that is my perfect shoe collection. I definitely have a lot more shoes, but these are the ones I'm wearing most at the moment. I'll leave links to all of these shoes down in the description if you want to pick them up for yourself. Other than that, thanks for watching, and I'll see you next week.